you cannot win. You're in a war that never ends. Making promises you just can't keep. Living with regrets that make you weep. Running out of time to close the door. On the very last where I was born. Shouting out the past so eyes of light. And now I'm in a stronger than my
obrigado. Muito, muito obrigado. São Paulo! It is an honor for us to be here. We want to thank every one of you for buying a ticket, for buying the ticket tonight, because it is you who bought the ticket. You are the reason we were able to come back here. So we thank you. From the new album, Promise and Terror, this is City of Bones.
Stand and fight! Stand and fight!
because of you believing in us. Everyone, there is no big record company. There is no EMI. There's no Sony Records. There is just us. Just us. And every one of you. Thank you. obrigado, muito, muito obrigado. We have a new album. It is called Promise and Tone. And tonight, we have the album with us. We have it with us, so I'm going to stay here, and if anybody wants to get that album tonight, I'm going to be there and I'm going to sign that album for you. And I don't care how long it takes, and if they close this club and say, you've got to get out, then I'll be on the street signing the fucking album for all of you. And if it takes all night, I don't care, because I'll go straight to the fucking airport from here in wet clothes for you. This is from the second part of the new album, Promise and Terror. It is called Letting Go of the World. I wonder what reason I have to live. Desperately I have searched for a meaning. Is it now time for me to let go of the world? fucking business, sir. And you are so fucking cool, man. This one is dedicated to every one of you tonight. It is dedicated to you because of your belief. Because everyone, I can see everyone in this room, you have your own confidence. You think for yourself. You choose the music that you like. You don't let people tell you what to do. You don't let people brainwash you and let you say, oh, you must listen to Shania Twain. You must listen to Britney Spears. Because we know that Blaze Bailey has the best fans of any band. You are the Brave.
Yeah!
songs from those days, from those beautiful days, and join us with our interpretation of the Klansman.
Freedom! Freedom! The right to believe and the need to be made. The power to deny. bottom of my heart, from my heart, then I thank everyone here tonight. I thank you from my heart. Thank you so much for bringing us here and giving us such a fantastic concert. Thank you. The album that we had last year, then it was made possible because of every one of you. And it's an album, it's about revenge. It's about revenge. Sometimes people will fuck with you and what you believe. And sometimes we have to hold on to what we believe and we have to fuck them right back. Sometimes we just can't. We can't fucking give up. This song is for you. You have created the man who would not die.
Fire, the dream, the way the light.
is the last one. Forget the rest of your life. Forget going home. Don't do anything except live your life now in these few minutes with us. That's it. There's nothing else. There's nothing else. There's nothing else. There's nothing else. Now, all of us, you, every motherfucker, every one of you, forget your life. You are here with us now. Live your life with us now. We'll be right back.
running with a God of speed.
Come on. camisetas pretas, piercings, patches, atitude e muito, muito som pesado. Dessa maneira aconteceu o segundo Abril True Metal, realizado pela Dream Cry. Aconteceu o segundo Abril True Metal, realizado pela Dream Cry Produções, no último domingo no Quadrilhó.
Remember Monsters of Rock on the Virtual 11. Monsters of Rock on the Virtual 11. So, remember it with Motorhead and Skid Row and Iron Maiden. It was, for me, it was the biggest gig ever in my life. Was here with you guys in San Paolo. It was fucking just scary, just fucking frightening, man, that gig. But I'll tell you something funny that happened, that he came off, what's his name, from Skid Row. Sebastian. Sebastian, right. He came off, and apparently a lot of you guys didn't like Skid Row very much that night. And Sebastian came off, and he said, "Blaze, the Maiden fans fucking hate us. They hate us. I want to go home." And this is true, man. This is true. I'll probably get sued for this. And he phoned up his manager the next day, and he says, "Look, we're going down terrible. Everyone in Brazil hates us. I want to come home." And his manager said, "No, you've been paid, you fucking stay there. Motorhead will go on after you, you go before Motorhead." So, man, it was so funny. But that's no one, I never told that story.
Frequência Rock tem a honra de entrevistar um dos maiores nomes do heavy metal mundial. Ele fez parte da maior banda de heavy metal do mundo, Iron Maiden. E ele está no Brasil divulgando o novo álbum Promise and Terror. E termina a parte da turnê brasileira aqui em Juiz de Fora. Blaze, como você se sente hoje aqui em Juiz de Fora?
It's been really great for us.
Foram 15 shows em 17 dias. Realmente foi cansativo. Eu fui aonde o fã estava. A ideia foi fazer como eu faço na Europa. Pequenos shows, com ingressos sempre baratos. Ou seja, ir aonde o fã está. Essa foi a grande ideia dessa turnê. E eu acho que eu consegui que essa turnê fosse um sucesso. Blaze, como está sendo a repercussão do novo álbum Promise and Terror?
The new album, Promise and Terror, just...
O novo álbum saiu praticamente junto com a turnê. Os fãs têm curtido muito as músicas novas ao vivo. E por isso já estou agendando um retorno ao Brasil em 2011. Blaze, você foi artista de uma grande banda. Agora você é um artista solo. Qual é a diferença de trabalhar numa grande banda e sendo você o chefe? A diferença entre tocar no Iron Maiden e a minha carreira solo é a proximidade que eu tenho com os fãs. E sempre após os shows, eu acho fantástico receber os fãs para dar autógrafos, tirar fotos. A menos que eu tenha um voo logo após o show, eu adoro fazer isso. E quando eu estava no Iron Maiden, os fãs ficavam muito distantes de mim, o que não acontece agora. Eu realmente gosto dessa proximidade com os fãs. Foi muito difícil trabalhar com o líder do Iron Maiden, Steve Harris?
It's the same as football, I think.
É como se fosse um time de futebol. O Iron Maiden é como se fosse a seleção da Inglaterra. Enquanto aqui, é como se estivesse jogando por um clube. Mas eu tenho muito orgulho do meu passado com o Iron Maiden. Mas eu acho que agora eu sou um artista mais maduro e o meu vocal está bem melhor. Você tem algum plano para lançar algum DVD, algum CD novo? Já está nos planos isso aí?
What we're trying to do is collect a lot of the clips.
É em primeira mão que eu vou dizer isso. Eu estou captando algumas imagens, sim, de vários shows dessa turnê na América do Sul, e talvez devemos lançar um DVD mostrando toda essa loucura que foram esses shows aqui no Brasil.
Como os decía anteriormente, esta noche tenemos una pues, gran estrella, de las muchas estrellas que poco a poco os vamos ofreciendo ya en aquí directos. Esta noche un ex Iron Maiden, Blaze Bailey, le tenemos en nuestro set de aquí directo, justo antes de saltar al escenario para darnos pues, este concierto, uno de los tres conciertos, como nos comentaba anteriormente Juan Pablo, que es su promotor, eran en Madrid, Santander y Barcelona. Él es Blaze Bailey. Blaze.
Hola, Hola Charlie.
Hello.
Hola Charlie. ¿Qué tal? ¿Cómo estás? Sí, más o menos bien.
So far.
Más o menos.
Blaze,
este álbum, Promesas y Terror, es editado con un modesto sello. Tú has estado en grandes compañías. Sí, en mi último sello.
Because I wanted freedom.
Porque
as an artist,
quiero ser libre. Quiero ser libre.
Yeah. Too many times.
Hace algún tiempo.
Then the big record.
En una gran compañía de discos. Trabajamos muy duro. No nos gustaba el sonido.
We don't want you to go on
no teníamos
tour
la libertad de poder tocar en distintos
or
lugares.
They said to me,
o me decían
we don't think
que
it's
lo más importante era la venta.
Me,
y para mí lo más importante
like
es poder ver a mis fans
and
y tocar.
For my kind of music, for heavy metal music,
para mí el
it's very
heavy metal
to play
es
live.
Muy importante para tocar en directo, de manera que ahora junto a un sello más modesto, yo y el resto de mi banda hacemos todo el trabajo. Nosotros tenemos la distribución, lo hacemos por toda Europa y llevamos CDs a los conciertos y más o menos lo llevamos muy bien. Somos libres en esto. ¿Crees que esta fórmula es mejor?
I'm not sure if it's,
no estoy seguro
if it's
si esta fórmula es la mejor para
me,
cada uno, pero para mí yo quiero tener mi música en el corazón. Quiero ver a mis fans. Para mí, lo más importante son mis fans. La gente que hace que una banda sea grande son sus fans.
That's what I believe in my heart. And I don't think record companies believe that.
Lo que hacen algunas compañías es llevarse los beneficios de los fans y de las bandas. De modo que para mí, para Blaze Valley Band, si la banda es potente es gracias a los fans, es lo más importante para mí. ¿Por qué no has venido a España en los últimos años? Tuve algunos problemas con mi anterior compañía de discos y con mi anterior manager. Y quiero estar donde están todos mis fans. En cada club, en cada sala, por pequeño que sea.
If we can afford to
si
get
ellos
there,
están allí,
there,
yo estaré
I wanna go there.
Con ellos.
And the record company
y la compañía de discos nos decía de no llevar CDs y mi manager no quería que tocásemos en sitios pequeños.
Said,
y yo creo que si recorremos miles de kilómetros para llegar hasta
but
tus fans,
I said, well,
te tienen que dar la facilidad de facilitar las cosas. Ahora con mi nueva compañía de discos y con mi nuevo manager hacemos muchos conciertos en España y regresaremos también a España. Es muy importante para mí. Lo llevo en el corazón. Vi algunos conciertos en España con Iron Maiden y los fans españoles son maravillosos, son muy generosos y estaremos muchos conciertos en España. Realmente les amo.
I really love it here. Play as many concerts as I can. So from now that's what we're trying to do.
Yeah. Okay.
¿Cómo ha sido tu vuelta?
It's fantastic. Last night was the first show.
Es fantástico. Anoche fue nuestra presentación y la reacción de la gente en España fue increíble, absolutamente increíble. Cuando los fans te apoyan es más fácil, cuando apoyan a la banda es más fácil para poder llegar a más ciudades. ¿Cómo tú que has estado tocando en grandes conciertos, en grandes estadios, cómo ahora te planteas tocar en salas más pequeñas? Para mí lo más importante es tocar a la gente en cada concierto. Me reúno con los fans para firmarles autógrafos antes y después de los conciertos con Iron Maiden. Es muy grande, es muy, muy peligroso por las grandes masas, de manera que así puedo acercarme a la gente, firmar autógrafos, hacer fotos y darles muchas gracias a los fans por el soporte que nos dan. ¿Has tenido contacto con otros miembros de Iron Maiden? Steve Harris, David Murray, Adrian Smith. Sí, sigo teniendo contactos. Estuve en un show de radio con Bruce Dickinson y algunas veces coincidimos. ¿Cuál es el plan que tienes ahora para el futuro? Quiero tocar en España lo más que sea posible y regresaremos sobre septiembre
o
octubre.
We're going to try and play some more shows in September or October, if we can.
Y si podemos, y quiero grabar un álbum en directo y poderlo editar en diciembre, editar el álbum Promesas y Terror en directo. Y para el próximo año, hacer todos los conciertos que podamos en España.
Thank you very much.
Muchas gracias, Blaze, por la entrevista.
Okay.
Cuídate. Que tengas esta noche un muy buen concierto en Santander.
And really, really looking forward, really excited about.
Muchas gracias.
And
a vosotros.
Really want to say, from my heart,
por mi corazón.
Muchas
gracias a todos los fans de España. Muchas gracias a todos.
Bueno, pues esta ha sido la entrevista con Blaze Bailey, ex Iron Maiden, que hoy está con su banda desde la sala Heaven en Carcicedo, en Santander.